Hi guys, welcome to Screen Guru. I am Aditi and I hope you all are doing well physically as well as mentally. Today in the basics of English grammar, we are going to talk about the concept of pronouns. Do go through this whole video but stay till the end because I want to talk about one aspect which is related to pronouns. Although it isn't really related to grammar, but again, it is very, very important that we all know about it, we all understand it, and that we also practice it. So please stay till the end. Let me know if you have any doubts.
Just then.
Pronouns are those words that are used as alternatives to the nouns in a sentence. They change according to the gender and number of the noun. Let us see this with an example. I love my dance teacher. She is very kind. Now, since the dance teacher is a female, the pronoun that we used is she. If the dance teacher would have been a male person, the sentence would have been, I love my dance teacher. He is very kind. Let us see the next sentence. My friends were coming over for my birthday. They all got me presents. We had fun. Now here, since there are more than one people involved, the pronoun that we used is a plural pronoun. They all got me presents. If it was a single friend, then the pronoun would have been dependent upon the gender of the noun, that is the friend. Now, let us see some types of pronouns. Personal pronouns, as the name suggests, talk about the pronouns that we use when we talk about one particular person, as in when I am talking in first person, I will use I. When I am talking in second person, I will use you. When I am talking in third person, I will use he or she or they. Demonstrative pronouns are used to indicate the place of a particular thing or a person. For example, this cake that is on the table, or that bag which is under the cupboard. Interrogative pronouns are those pronouns which are used to ask a question. They are also popularly known as the 5 W's. Relative pronouns are those pronouns which are used to start a relative clause so that we do not have to repeat the subject of the main clause. For example, this is the book which XYZ author wrote, or this is the friend who I was telling about the other day. Possessive pronouns tell us to whom a particular thing or person belongs to. For example, this food is mine, that book is yours. Indefinite pronouns are those pronouns which are used when we are not talking about one particular person or a group. Here, we are being vague. For example, each person should take benefit of this scheme, or I hope that everyone is comfortable with my teaching style. This was a genuine question, guys. I hope you are comfortable with my teaching style. And that is it for pronouns. I hope you are understanding everything. If you have any doubts, please reach out to us in the comment section below. If you find this video useful, please share it with your friends or anyone who would be in need of it. And if you like it, please like the video. Thank you.
By sheer coincidence.
First of all, thanks a lot for staying till the end. And now for the thing that I wanted to share with you guys is that let's say there is a baby which is born in the male sex. The baby grows up and realizes that they adhere more to the female gender. This person is a transgender, and they will tell you that their correct pronouns are she and her.
even if grammatically you think that their pronouns should be that of a male pronoun, but it is about their own personal preference. So you have to go according to the correct pronoun that this person is mentioning. Also, there are people who do not adhere to either of the binary genders. They are called agender and they prefer to have their correct pronouns to be they and them. What can you do in all this scenario? Every time you meet a new person, make it a norm that you ask them about their correct pronouns. This way, not only do you help normalize this whole thing, but in a way, you are also helping the marginalized LGBTQ community. And let's be all fair and square. It is completely natural. It is completely biological. It is completely scientific. There is nothing wrong in it. There is nothing to be taboo about. So let us all be responsible citizens. And I hope you all understood this. It is a very sensitive issue indeed. If you have any questions, any queries, do reach out to us anytime. We would get through to you as soon as possible. Thanks a lot again for watching the video till the end.
Just then.
आज हमने कर दिया तो कह रहे हम करेंगे तो करो ना भाई।